Hey guys, welcome to my channel. This is my attempt, my second attempt at a pour. Feel free to like or subscribe. Right now I'm using a scale to measure out my acrylics and my liquid. I do one part acrylic and half a part of liquid water usually. There are some who use Floetrol. I don't have it, so I'm using what I have, which is water. And for me, a scale helps, and soon enough I'll be able to do it without the scale and just eyeball it and tell off how it moves and how it flows and how thick it is. I use a scale because I'm comfortable with the scale, and if you're not, if you'd rather not use a scale, that's fine too. If you do want to use a scale, I say go for it. It helps. That's my 20 karat gold. I'm using two blues, 20 karat gold. I have Caribbean blue and a really metallic dark blue. And I'm using white as a paste as well. I'm trying the double helix pour the second time. And first I'm going to pour my base, which is just my white paint mixed with water. Remember, you should always pour, some sort of pre-base on it so that your liquid can flow much more smoothly. You don't have to pour a base liquid, but I think it helps. I'm pouring in silicone. I put in about 3 or 4 drops of silicone in there to help form some cells. Now I am pre-pouring, like tracing out the outline I wanted to have, and sometimes I'll do that, and it just gives me a better control of how fast to move and which way I want my liquid to go. Pouring my 20K down the middle. I'm really hoping I get this double helix attempt, the second attempt. And right now I'm trying again in my second attempt at using a blow dryer. For me, it doesn't work. I'm not sure what I'm doing wrong, but I'll try again a few more times before I officially give up on the blow dryer. I just went and used my straw method, and for me it works. don't mind my face in the camera. Sometimes it might be in there. Right now, I'm actually enjoying this part of getting somewhat of a double helix shape. But I'm not completely happy with it, to be honest, so I'm gonna change it. And that's the benefits of doing an acrylic pour. You can change it at any point. My cardboard sidewalk so I could actually catch some of the paint that falls off the side. It actually does look nice at times when it does get kind of mushed up on the edges. Straw to blow and into the shape I want, or at least into the pattern that I want. And yes, it does take a lot of work, a lot of blowing, but if you enjoy it, then it's not work, it can be fun. Bits of paint. Because I didn't have enough before. And if you can see the edges right now, I do love the way the edges look. You guys can't see the painting right now, but I will get better at these camera shots. Remember, pouring can take a while. And if you're wondering why I'm trying to get the last bits of this white out of the cup, is because it does have silicone in it, and at this point I'm curious to see what the cells would look like if I poured the silicone paint on top of it. And they do form a cell of sorts, and it's interesting, but I don't keep it. I might keep it on the next attempt. Now I'm just filling in the sides that didn't get any paint, and I'm also scraping off the bottom so the paint doesn't dry on the bottom in a sort of droplet form. for me, I am progressively not happy with the outcome of this one. But I did learn lessons, such as pouring the silicone paint on top of the acrylic paint and what it looks like. And I will try that again at another time. Right now I'm just using my torch to see if I can get some of the cells to come through, and I don't think I put enough paint with the cells on that edge. And remember, you just want the heat to touch the canvas. You don't want the actual flame touching anything. And as long as I'm trying it, you can see that no cells are coming through, and that's okay. At this point, my daughter does join me, and she's asking me if she could help, and I actually have to tell her no, but she tries anyway. She has her own little conversation with me. She's trying to blow with her mouth at this point, and then gives up. Goes back to her tablet. And I try to get some cells to form again, but nothing's happening at this point. And I'm not really happy with this. It's, if you can tell, the colors are muddied. They blended together, so I did too much. This is a learning process, and any tips are always welcome. So this one is a failed project for me, but I will start over with it.